Just a disclaimer from editing Ryan, this vlog includes two parts really, because I just filmed the whole week and then I put it all together. I'm not going to split it into two videos. I just want to film the whole week, whether it's to do with filming or whatever, photography or whatever, and then just put it together. I'll put here the time that the half marathon footage starts, and then before that, the start of the video, you will see the stuff where I filmed with David and Rob, that agency guys, and did a photography challenge. So you've got two things, photography challenge and then the half marathon, trip down to London and street photography in London. So that's basically this video. I know it's a bit all over, but yeah, it was tough. I need to improve my skills in vlogging a little bit, so I can piece all these things together better. But yeah, these clips are kind of thrown together in this one. It was a little bit all over. I didn't expect the half marathon to come so quick, so I thought it was on Tuesday, as I'll explain in the video, but it turned out to be Saturday, so it was a bit of a rush around and I just filmed whatever I could. And yeah, it's mainly for me to look back on, but if you are watching this as a viewer, I just wanted to explain that first. So yeah, I hope you enjoy this two-part vlog, I guess.
Hello and welcome back to my vlog. My name's Ryan and today I'm with the vlog kings.
Welcome to Ryan's world.
Hijacking my vlog today. We've got that David and that Roberto. Can I call you Roberto?
I mean, you barely
know my name then. I call him Charlie, so.
You took ages to say my name, so I don't even know if you know it.
Roberto. And yeah, we're going to head out and we're going to do a shoot today. None of us really know what we're going to do.
No.
But we'll figure it out.
We're going to capture some cool places in Doncaster.
Yeah, that's the thing. I think the message behind this video is, no matter where you live, you can still get great photos, great content. I mean, I'm not saying Doncaster's terrible, but, you know, you can find those...
yeah, you can find Doncaster's those, a shithole.
You can find those, you know, beautiful spots anywhere and get some great photos anywhere. So, yeah, that's the message behind today's vlog, and we're going to head out and get going. First location where we're going to be taking photos. So what we're going to be doing is we're going to have three locations we're going to go to today, and from each location we're going to pick one photo that we really like, and one of them has to be a portrait, one of them has to be a landscape, and then we can pick the third one ourselves. So it can be another portrait or another landscape, and yeah, and then we're going to post the photos after at the end of this video, and you can let us know whose you like the most, whose you prefer, and yeah, get straight to some shooting.
I feel like we do a vlog clip and then Ryan's just got to repeat it for his vlog.
Yes.
Oh, I broke your Joby.
Oh, Christ.
So we just had an idea for me to be like this. This happens to all these pairs of jeans as well. For me to be like this. But if you want to go down there, I've got a big hole there.
Right, do you want me to sit exactly like this, or do you want me up more upright? Or... No, that's
fine. Look at him. Born to be a model.
I wish me. 5'4".
Look at this.
Yeah, you could be a model for age 7 to 8 clothing.
So we're finished at that location. We're heading to the next one. We're going to Lakeside in Doncaster. Behind the scenes of what that agency go listen to in car. The band's called
this
Petrol
even,
Bastards, by the way.
Even the worst of it.
This is what we do to get psyched up to go and film packaging.
I mean, we're doing this collaboration video with old Gadsby here, and I don't know where he's taking us. He's just taking us in some weird bushes.
Here we are, look, second location. We're going to get some cool photos around here.
This is the most scenic place I've sat to eat a Belgian bun in a while.
I think all this outdoorsness has gone to our head. Outdoorsness.
The vlog's on, you can fall now.
And on, this is how you know when you're getting old, you walk down hills like this. This is how you know.
This is way steeper than the camera makes it look.
You do this wide. Look at this.
Well, you should be going down backwards doing the vlogging then.
Like, have you got me a stick, Rob? Have you got me a stick?
He's saying this, but who's walking down backwards vlogging? So,
here we are again. Walking through some weird mad bushes and stuff. Actually, we are in the middle of the Lakeside Lake, and it's a pretty cool place, you know. I always forget that we've got this on our doorstep, and it's actually a really cool place. Like, if you want to come and just like have an hour for your dinner or whatever, or you know, have a walk around, get a little bit of exercise in, or just chill out for a bit, it is a really cool place. We used to live not far from here, and we used to fetch kids here all the time, several times a week, just like chill out, have a little picnic and stuff like that. I mean, I say picnic, we go to McDonald's and fetch any here. My town, Doncaster, is absolutely banging. I don't care what anyone says. It's got some class stuff in it. Hasn't it, Doncaster? Come on, back me up.
Our way to another location, the last one. Yeah, I'm excited to see what photos we've got. You guys have already seen some of them already, so. Right, so we've finished at our last location. All the photos done now. So how do you think it went, guys? I think it went all right?
I think it's gone brilliantly, yeah. I'm really looking forward to seeing what I can get for my Instagram.
New profile picture.
This ain't the most comfortable part of the walk, and sort of part that I damaged my ankles on, like I mentioned earlier.
Yeah, don't break your ankle. Right, we're back at their office, and we're having a look at some of the photos that we've took. I've just had a look at a couple of mine, but Rob's found one that he really likes.
Of one of the photos. Oh my word, that is a class photo as well.
I love it, it's cool.
I'm just a little bit good at the best photos, not me.
Well, I've got this one of you.
Oh, we'll save that for the vlog another time.
I've got photos like that, and I've got photos like that.
The quality difference is absolutely unreal. I suppose that's...
That is actually not a bad photo, with a bit of edit.
It's a good photo of a shoe, yeah.
With a bit worn looks sole. Like chewing gum on the bottom.
Yeah, it's, I don't know what it is, but you've worn it a lot, clearly.
Yeah, yeah.
They're
my gym shoes.
These are the initial ones, so like, they don't look bad, to be fair. You started talking, so we've got a lot of just like...
Yes, that's the one for...
Yeah. All done with the challenge now. I'm gonna head off and get on with the rest of my day. I just want to say thank you to these guys for collabing with me. Really appreciate it.
No problem.
I definitely go and check out their blog. They do it daily. Absolute mad heads. Don't know how they keep up with it daily. But yeah, go and check them out. I'll leave the link to their channel in the description to this video. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed that challenge, and I'll skip to Saturday. You know how I said I'd see you on Saturday? It's actually Friday today, and it's a bit of a funny story actually, but I'm actually going down to London. I won't be doing any, I was gonna do some food photography. That's what I was booked for Saturday. But basically, you know that half marathon I spoke about on the first vlog episode? Well, it turns out that, on the last vlog episode, actually, it turns out that that is Saturday, not Tuesday. I thought it was Tuesday. So I thought I was getting the train Monday to London to then run on Tuesday. But actually, I'm getting the train today down to London in about an hour. And I'm going down. I literally found out at like 10 o'clock last night. So I've been getting all my stuff like rush packed. I'm packed up now, ready to go. Got my running shoes and everything like that. I know this channel is mainly about photography and stuff, but I do want to share, you know, little bits of my life that I do outside. So, and also we're going to be doing some cool street photography in London as I'm walking around checking out some bits on Saturday. So I'll try and get some really cool snaps while I'm down there. Yeah, get some really cool photos in London. And I'll also vlog my half marathon. I've done a couple half marathons and I'm also running it with my auntie Hannah. So she has a house near London, an apartment near London. So I'm going to be staying there tonight and then we're going to get up early Saturday morning to then run. Yeah, it'll be a steady one, a chill one, but I'm hoping to get a good look around Battersea Park, which is where it is. It's Battersea Park Half Marathon. So that's the one we're doing. Really excited to go down there and also eat some good food, hopefully, in London on Saturday, because London has some really good food compared to where I live in Doncaster. So yeah, got my stuff packed. I'll show you my massive bags that I'm taking down for one night stay. I apologize for the mess, but I've got my big bag here. This has got my running shoes in, my running clothes, my camera in here. I'll let you have a little look. You see the camera's down there. You can see there. Wrapped up, snug, with all my clothes, just so it doesn't get broke. So in here, I've just got clothes, got my laptop in the back. In here, I've got all my other stuff ready to go. I'll just hat and toothbrush and all that good stuff. But yeah, honestly, it was such a rush last night. I was like, because my auntie Hannah messaged me and she was like, oh, you ready for Saturday? And I was like, Saturday? It's Tuesday, isn't it? And I said to my girlfriend, Sophie, you know that race, is it Saturday or Tuesday? And she was like, it's Tuesday, isn't it? You said 17. So I'm like, let me have a look. Went and checked. No, it's Saturday. So yeah, I was like running all over last night, washing some clothes, like getting some clothes ready, looking for my running stuff. I can't find my proper running top. I wear the same running top for the races I've done. Let's talk abuse top. But yeah, so I haven't explained on this channel. So basically I'm fundraising for survivors of child sexual abuse and rape. This is like personal to me, close to my heart. If you want to read my story, you can go and check out my other Instagram, The Edge of the Bed. On Instagram, on YouTube. Yeah, so that's the other side of me. I say the other side of me, it's a part of me, fully who I am, but this page, obviously, I don't go into that too much. But, you know, it is a part of me, and this channel is my channel. So, yeah, I will share this part with you. And, you know, if you want to know more about that, if you're a survivor yourself, go over to The Edge of the Bed on Instagram or YouTube. So, yeah, I'm going to head down to the train station in about, I don't know, like probably in about half an hour, actually. Get there nice and early, make sure I don't miss my train. So yeah, I'm gonna get going. And that's it. Arrived at London's King's Cross Station. Get that out then. So I've got to go over to St Pancras now, the other train station, to get the train to where I'm staying, my auntie's apartment. So nearly there now, getting tired of these massive bags.
Thought you knew this, I don't really do this, move it like a Judas, talking all that talk but ain't no time for acting foolish, when you ask all the brothers saying true this, I might just jump on this for free, jumping on them freestyles, I be wild, moving brains, see now, it's so sunset, it's beautiful, it's one guest, one morning, afternoon in that sundress.
Right, so I've made it to every morning, London, still I said that at the train station, but I've made it to before, where my auntie Hannah lives. And yeah, this is where I'm going to be staying for tonight, and then we're going to get up early tomorrow and get ready for the half marathon. But for now, we're going to go look at some nice places to take some photos. So yeah, I'll show you what we're going to get up to.
As if we never knew.
For this view here, Hannah's brought me to this fancy view of the city. Got some nice pictures, I'll show you them now.
Especially brothers from the south side, but been about mine ever since the drought line. You put me benefit on this cloud nine.
I can't believe this view. Time starting
front light, nothing will change until it drains. Ain't nothing the same. Cause you become like the blood in my veins. Saying I'm way too young to be stuck on the rain. And still it's peak weeks till I figured out you play keys. 18, you were listening to JD, blaming the main trees, telling me you play.
Now, chilling on a boat.
I've been too busy getting dizzy, got that JD, dreaming of it, chasing.
These
days are feeling cold. So now we're in Shoreditch. I've been taking some little snaps on the street and stuff. So I'll show them now. I was too young for you. Where are we heading?
Shoreditch,
Brick Lane. So we're going to Brick Lane. Later on, we're going to get something to eat.
Chicken.
Yeah, some chicken. We've been talking about chicken wings, and now we both fancy some chicken wings. So, yeah. I know that these days are feeling cold. I didn't update the vlog last night, but basically went for food, came back and went straight to sleep, ready for today. And then we're off for the race now, off for the half marathon. So we're gonna get the train down there. And yeah, smash out this half marathon. You feeling ready for it?
No.
No. Me neither. I know that these days are feeling cold. My love could take her home, as if we never knew. And we are going, just started, got a long way to go, but I'm feeling pretty fresh, pretty good, so yeah, we'll see how this goes. Are you done? Oh, long way to go, but I'm trying to smash out the 10k first, faster pace, slow it down at middle, and then finish it with a faster 5k. I'm feeling pretty alright, so I think we can do it at a pretty decent time. 15k in, fucking getting tough now, but I keep reminding myself why I do this. It just pushes me on. Oh, not long to go. 17.5k in, my body's fucked, I've got nothing left really, but this is my head going now. Just keeping me going, I can't. My legs, can't feel them. Yeah, it's tough. Finished the half marathon. The time were 1 hour 39, sub 140. Not bad at all. I think that towards the end, that's the hardest thing I've ever done in my life. Hardest thing, hands down. I don't even know how I got through it, to be honest. I'm so hungry. My legs are wobbly as fuck. And I can hardly stand up. I'll be able to sit down. I won't get back up. Yeah, I've proper done it. Just gotta wait for Hannah now. Yeah. All finished now, the race is done. I'm gonna go out, get some food, refuel, and then probably go out and take some more photos later. So, and then you can see, yeah, what I take there. So yeah, gotta grab some food, because I am starving after that. I'm quite happy with the time. I think the pace I did was, I don't even know how I did it, to be honest. But yeah, it was a push the last couple of minutes, but we got it done, so. Yeah, super happy and excited to do another one now. Here's a posh little medal as well. There we go. So I haven't done many updates today. I'm just exhausted from the half marathon. But I am at King's Cross now. King's Cross Station. My auntie Hannah is going to stay at a friend's because she's flying to America tomorrow. So I'm just going to... She's recommended going down to this coal yard, I think it's called. So I'm gonna head down there. Apparently there's a nice canal there, take some photos. And get something to eat. And yeah, it's so sunny, it's so nice. Like, just outside King's Cross, they have like this little Spanish bar set up, like just sitting there in the sort of lounge, felt like I was in Spain. But it's been such a cool like weekend, surprise weekend, because I thought this was gonna happen Tuesday, but yeah, it's been really, really cool. I hope it's been entertaining for yous. I just think it's been tough to get B-roll and stuff, walking around with these like bags. But yeah, I've got some pretty cool photos. But you know, I just enjoyed my time a little bit and didn't like force myself to get loads of photos. But yeah, oh, I'm so tired. That's the thing with half marathons. I didn't feel much cardio fatigue or anything like that. But it's just afterwards, like, well, I say I didn't feel cardio fatigue. That's a lie. Obviously, I did. But not as much. It was more my legs aching. Like after, you just get so tired and just so drained. So hopefully get some sugary food in me, and then it'll wake me up a little bit. And then yeah, chill out. I train to 8, get back on the train, back to Donny, good old Donny, Yorkshire. Yeah, so I'll just skip to when I get to the call yard, because I'm sure you don't want to see me walk all the way there. So.
So it's the day after Battersea Park half marathon, and as you can tell, I've just laid down. Yeah, I'm exhausted still, even the day after. It's like evening time now. But I thought I'd close off the vlog just by saying thank you to everyone. I'll sit up, you know, be respectful. just by saying thank you to everyone who donated. So far we've raised just over £200, which, you know, isn't bad considering I posted the link just a few days before the run. So yeah, we basically raised £200 in a few days. So yeah, it's amazing to see everyone support that, this important cause. And you know, if this topic affects you personally, feel free to check out the Edge of the Bed page that I have as well. So yeah, it's been a packed video from the very start, you know, with David and Rob, and then rushing off to London, even though I thought that was next week. But yeah, it's been really, really fun, and I'm excited to show you guys what we get up to next week, photo wise and creative wise. It's going to be a cool week. So yeah, thank you all for watching as well, and I will see you all in the next video.